I grew up in a family with four women, like my aunties and my mom. They are four, all of them are artists and very creative people. So my passion came from that. My mom also, she's a businesswoman and she always buy a lot of paintings, and I have been surrounding around pieces of art in my home. Mainly naked ladies. That's why probably I like to draw that in the way of feminism, and it's the figure, the representation for me when I illustrate. Normally, as an artist, to get inspired, you need to walk around and see, observe a lot, and it's depending on the project you are working on. For example, if I need to do research online, it's fine. In my room, I'm fine to get inspired. And I love my space. It's quite plain, white. For me, it's very important to have a clean studio. I normally do digital. There are many other techniques that I have tried, as lino cut, for example, or screen print are very exciting, but I enjoy the digital process. It's quicker than the process on paper. So if I go back to tell you about the paper, I use the line markers, then I have to scan and digitalize, so it take a while to get the final piece of artwork. So I like to observe, I like to look at magazines, internet, Pinterest. So for example, if I need to draw a girl on a bike, I go to do research about a lot of girls, naked ladies, normally trying naked ladies on a bike, and then I start my drawings from there, and then I develop the rest of the ideas, sometimes through my imagination, sometimes through other resources as plants or... When I was studying my master, I realized that it wasn't about learning how to draw, it was about loving what you do. And when I learned that, I started feeling like I was an illustrator. I was loving what I was doing. That was what I wanted to do for the rest of my life. At the end, the art talks by itself. Like when you do something that you really love, it transmits to people. Night could last forever. Leave the sun shine out. Say hello to never. All the people are dancing and they're having such